Hello. Hello and welcome to the first event. I'm lazy and sitting on the stage because I just don't give a shit. To the first event before the competition tonight, we have the Atari Scene Awards. This is an award show to honor the Atari and everything it stands for. And here on stage is Havok, who's going to tell us all about it, and I'll get up as well and come on stage. Yes, I have cable. So, the Atari Scene Awards is very important to the Atari scene.
It is, yeah. Well, it's the first time we're organizing this thing, and the idea behind this is, of course, to get an to make an election which prop was the best in this year, but also to honor a few people who have contributed in other ways than just making props to the scene, which is something that we think is quite necessary in this rather small scene to keep it alive and vibrant.
To give props. And to be clear, we have three categories. And a lifetime category. Two categories. We have two categories.
Two categories, yeah.
And a lifetime category, or just one?
No, we have one best prod of 2010 category, and then we have the lifetime achievement.
The lifetime achievement award. Which is the man with the most Atari tattoos.
That's it, exactly. We counted them all and from
all
top
places
to bottom,
you don't want to know.
Exactly.
So we start with the best production on Atari in 2010.
That's right, yeah. We got quite a lot of votes, about 40 plus, and that's only from active Atari scenes.
40 Atari scenes is a lot in the Atari scene.
Yeah.
Should be more though, but it is still, I mean, still 40 plus plus.
Considering where we promoted this awards vote, man, it's quite a lot. Next year we're planning to open it up for voting to other seniors as well. But yeah, this was a first tryout. So.
It was a first tryout, so interns. Okay, so you have the nominees first.
Well, nominees, we had open voting. So there were 16 productions that were mentioned by the voters. A few of them only got one vote. And yeah, there's actually three prods that clearly stood out.
Are you going to tell them all?
Yes, I'm going to tell them starting by
shall
the...
Shall I put some suspense? Number three.
Number three from the Atari 8-bit scene, a Polish production by La Résistance called Control.
Number three, best production of the
camp. Number two.
Number two, another Atari 8-bit production, but this time from Germany. It's City Things by Jack.
And now, number one.
Number one is a production that was clearly voted number one, not only by the Atari ST Sceners, the platform that it was released on, but also by Atari 8-bit and Falcon Sceners. There was obviously a lot of agreement about which prod should be the number one this year. It's from Sweden, it runs on Atari ST, and it's Talk Talk 2 by Excellence in Art. We're going to show, because unfortunately at this moment Excellence in Art himself is not around at this party, which we dearly regret, like he does, but we contacted him and asked him if he had any message for the people here in Eersel, and yes, he does have a message, which is why Nianoki will leave the stage now and do the talking.
Hey everybody, my name is Per, and I released Atari stuff labeled Excellence in Art. I'm sorry I can't be with you at Outline. I know you're having a great time over there. And thank you. I'm honored and I'm a bit moved. Talk Talk to the Church of Excellence in Art was a lot of work and it means a lot to me that you guys liked it. The Atari scene has always meant a lot to me. It's given so much over these 20-something years. And I love each and every one of you. Some extra love to the people helped out. Evil, of course, for the support. Calms with Black Lotus for some extra code. Gwen for the wonderful Maximizer. Without Maximizer, this demo could not have been done. Maximizer is the central nervous system of that entire demo. And to GGM for the compatibility fixes so more people could watch the demo. So, again, thank you so much, all of you. And remember, let love rule. always. Bitches.
Are we going to watch it now?
I think that might be a good idea.
Yes!
Yeah, yes. Yeah. Okay, let's start it. Yeah.
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 Full screen is not possible because of stupid limits.
Windows 7.
Windows. Because. Shut up, Bob.
Stupid Norwegian.
Where's the music?
Remember back in the day on Atari, things just ran?
That's true. Nothing ever broke down.
Nothing ever broke.
Never.
Impeccable machine.
Yes, it was.
Made from brawn and many things. That was a great moment. So yes, that brings us to the second and last award to be handed out here.
That's true, yeah.
Lifetime Achievement.
The Lifetime Achievement Award. We actually assembled a small group of experienced Atari seniors to choose who would be the most deserving person to win the first Lifetime Achievement Award award in the history of the Atari Scene Awards. And it actually took very little time to decide who that would be. It's a guy above everyone who is in the Atari scene knows him for sure, and probably most people outside also know him.
Do I know him?
I think so. You never met him in person, probably, but you know him. You know who it is.
Is it Justin Bieber?
No, though he is in the Atari scene.
Yes, he is in the Atari scene. If you didn't know, Justin Bieber is. Continue.
Yeah, first time I heard about this guy was back in 1993 or 1994. I heard him snoring, actually. And that's not a joke, it's actually true. We heard him snoring in the hallway at a big German Atari party, and we thought there was a big fat German sleeping, snoring in the hallway. So we decided to make some video of it, and never thought back of that moment until about 6-7 years later, when I was talking to one of my dear Swedish friends in the Atari scene online, and he was telling me about a situation where he heard some people walking around him in the hallway at a big German Atari party back in the 90s, and it turned out that this was actually the same person. We had just mistakenly assumed that he was German, and he is actually Swedish. So, without further ado, it's Evil of Dead Hacker Society.
Yes, and he is not here. He is not here.
He is not here, unfortunately. No. He doesn't like flying a lot, and he's decided not to come to this party, but he is here in spirit, and he has prepared, instead of a movie, because he doesn't like being on camera either, he prepared a little thank you intro, which we will be showing
right now. So give it up for Evil of the Dead Hacker Society, Lifetime Achievement! Hours to years. There will be competitions shortly. Starting with 100.